Hello guys, today I'm going to do a quick curtain tutorial and show you guys the best kind of methods for doing it quick and painlessly. Okay, so to start we're going to just delete everything in the scene already. Add a plane, rotated it in the y-axis 90 degrees by doing RY 90. Okay, and here we'll scale it up. So here, the way I'm going to add geometry to it is I'm actually not going to subdivide it. I'm going to use Control R to add lengthwise cuts. And you really need to add quite a few to get a really good simulation. Then I'm going to add some going like this. You actually don't need as many, just because most of the deformations will be along the other cuts. So Control R, use the scroll wheel to add more, and then just press Enter. Okay, so along the top vertices, we're just going to use hook modifiers. So just select one close to the edge, Control H. And we're going to need around four or five or six hooks along the top edge. So select those vertices and then just hit Control H to add those empties next to them. Those hooks will allow us to modify the mesh during this simulation, which is going to allow for some interesting geometry. After that, you need to create a vertex group. So select the same vertices that you did before, but this time you're going to be shift selecting them to be so you can select them simultaneously. Then you can go to object data, hit plus in vertex groups, and make sure you hit assign. This will group all of these vertices as a vertex group. If you deselect and select, you're going to see that now they're all together. These are going to function as the pins for a curtain, which is going to allow everything else to kind of drape and smooth and be affected by gravity, but these are all going to stay in place. Okay, so next we can actually add the cloth, enable the cloth physics. So just go to the physics tab, enable physics for cloth. We're going to use the silk preset, so you access the presets by clicking this little bulleted list. Editing silk. Silk has the lowest damping values, and this is going to allow for your cloth to settle in ways that's going to make it appear smooth and going to reduce the amount of intersecting geometry, which is bad and will look ugly. So for object collision, that's under the collision tab. Make sure object collision and self collision is checked in. Again, self-collision is just going to prevent the curtain from going into itself. And then in shape, make sure for the pin group, you select group. And that's the vertex group we created earlier. Finally, before starting it, just select the cloth in object mode. Go to object and enable smooth shading, shade smooth. And then go back into object data and under normals, enable auto smooth. And crank that up to 180. And just a couple more things. Under cache, we're gonna give it 500 frames so it has plenty of time to be able to settle down after we mess with it. Okay, this should be good. So then just hit the play button. As you can see, it's already moving, but we're gonna make it move more. So shift select these empties that were created earlier, and you can do SY and start messing with it. And so just do this a couple times and then just let it hang there for a bit. Because the material is silk, everything should settle out quite nicely, but it's also very common that you have some intersecting geometry and you might need to run the simulation one more time. So we're just gonna let it go until 500. Or near 500, so I'll stop at like 490 or something. Okay, great. Oh, let's see. Oh yeah, so I'm just gonna let this go until 500 again, and then I'm actually gonna use the play button to stop this time. And there we go. So here, let's take a look at it. So there is a little bit of roughness here, but As far as I can tell, nothing looks too messed up. You can usually tell it's messed up when you have any faces that are beyond 180, and the smooth shade will not be able to smooth them out. But this looks fine for the most part, so I'm gonna go with this. Again, feel free to re-simulate as many times as you want. If you're gonna do that, I recommend saving the file now so you can continue simulating it. And after you've done that, click File Save As and save it as something like Curtains Applied. That way you have one file where you can continue simulating, and then you have another file where you have something that's almost finished and you can export it. But if you ever need to go back, you can just open the unapplied file, and these modifiers are still here for you to mess with. Okay, so here I'm just gonna hit apply on all of these. When you hit apply on all of these, it'll save the state of the mesh as it currently is being simulated, and when you go into edit mode, you can see all of that. So finally, if we're gonna be using this for a game or something, we really want to reduce the amount of tries as much as possible. Right now we have 2700, but we can get that down by going to add modifier and decimate. The best mode for curtains I found is planar decimate, and already, oh, it's only down to 2500. So we can increase this angle limit. And that can really keep being increased until you start to see some irregularities in the mesh. Yeah, that there's one right there, so I don't really want to go much beyond that. So I think 8.8 is fine here, and we're down to 2100 tries. If this curtain was a little smoother, like right now the folds are really thick, it could probably even go down to below 1000. I've achieved that before, but because this curtain is a bit geometrically complex, I'm gonna be okay with this. So 2000 tries is it's not great, but it's not horrific either. So yeah. Okay, and there's your basic curtain here. Again, you could achieve a lot of different results. You can even add a turbulent physics object there by adding a sphere. And if you go to physics, you can add turbulence. So force field, turbulence. Okay, it didn't like that at all. So I might have to, you might have to start over with a new plane, which is why I recommend saving a version with the cloth modifier still unapplied. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and good luck. Leave any questions in the comments if you can get it working, and I'll see if I can help.